Well, hello everyone out there. Good morning. We're about to get things started, but we'd like to let you know what's going on so that you can get situated, grab your phone, your computer, bring us up on Apple TV, Roku, you name it, or even watch us live from the comfort of your hotel on outside television. Good morning, Ken Hovey here at Beaver Creek. We have a great program for you. Trisha's back at the studio with What Made Headlines, Weather and Mountain Reports. I'll be here in Beaver Creek talking with Rachel with the Beaver Creek Resort Company to find out about the holiday festivities, as well as one of my good friends, an Olympian, Jake Pates, about his program called Happy Healthy Brain. And it all starts right now. You're watching VDL.
Hi, I'm Trisha Swenson.
I'm Brazzo.
I'm Ashley.
I'm Ken Hovey.
I'm Meredith Kirkman.
I'm Ty Diaz.
I'm Charlie Kennedy.
We are VDL.
We are VDL.
We are VDL.
Vail Daily Life.
We are VDL.
VDL.
We are VDL.
Good morning, everyone. I'm Trisha Swenson reporting to you live from our studios here in Eagle Vale on this Tuesday, the 21st of December. It is the winter solstice today. It's the shortest day of the year in the northern hemisphere, the longest day of the year in the southern hemisphere. I think winter officially begins right around 9 o'clock a.m. our time this morning. A lot of people will maybe do a special yoga class. I think the West End is doing a special yoga class for this day as we transition into winter. So fall is officially ending. Winter is beginning. So thank you for joining us today. We're going to give you some weather details right now. So we want to let you know what's happening. Temperature-wise, a little balmy. We're seeing 17 degrees around Vail, Beaver Creek. Yeah, almost 20 out there. We are a little cooler down in Eagle, 11 degrees when I last checked. If you liked yesterday, you're going to like today. Our high is going to be in the upper 30s, and we'll see plenty of sunshine for today. Winds not too bad, maybe a few gusts, about 12 miles per hour. So nothing really to report on. And then overnight lows tonight will drop back into the teens. And then for your Wednesday, mostly sunny with a high in the low 40s, but then building clouds later on in the afternoon. And then by Thursday, hopefully, we're going to see those snow showers roll in. And that is going to continue through Christmas Eve day, Christmas Eve night, Christmas Day. So snow showers in the forecast. And according to opensnow.com, Joel Gratz over there, they're saying that we could maybe see 2 inches at Beaver Creek on Thursday, 2 inches at Vail on Thursday, and then 10 at Beaver Creek on Friday, and 9 on Friday over in Vail. So that's what we're hearing from Open Snow. So hopefully that will come true and we'll have a truly white Christmas out there. But I want to thank the Outlets at Silverthorne for this weather report. Elevated Savings, if you're still looking for holiday gift giving ideas, they can help you. They got all the stores and all the different villages for everyone on your shopping list. But if we could take it out to Ken Hovey, he is standing by live at Beaver Creek once again. And Ken, want to talk a little bit about the terrain. You know, no new snow to report, of course, in the last 24 hours. But I know that more terrain opened up last weekend. I had a chance to get out into Game Creek Bowl, and only half a Game Creek Bowl. You know, it's not the side like where Uzo is. You know, that's still closed because that faces south. It gets more sun exposure. But Lost Boy, Dealer's Choice, they were open. And at Beaver Creek, now we have lift number 16 for you open out of Bachelor Gulch. So Sawbuck is what they've been skiing.
And great point on Game Creek, Tricia. I was there on Sunday. Noticed the same thing. Conditions are fun. A little bit busier, you know, with the holidays approaching. I'm actually going online right now and doing some screen grabs. This is what I always recommend to our viewers. We love to bring you the ski conditions for Vail and Beaver Creek, but oftentimes you have it right there at the convenience of the palm of your hand by simply going to beavercreek.com. There's their report. It gives you the past week, it's total for the season. And also if you go to Vail for Beaver Creek, no new snowfall, as you mentioned, Tricia. They have a 38-inch base depth, 69 inches for the season. And in the past week, in the past 7 days, 9 inches of snow.
Yeah.
And with the promise or the hopes of having some snow this week, it does look promising. Yesterday, really bright, sunny skies, a few more clouds today. And by the week's end, we could have a few more inches. But Tricia, let's talk about this real quick, because we get to be honest with people on this program, about the holiday crowds. You and
yeah.
I have both seen it. It's already starting to happen on the slopes, right? You and I love to ride, but I'm going to go out there and say it right now. For locals, and you're like, whatever, Ken Obi, man, I'm going to get a million vertical feet in the next 3 days. Sit this one out, right?
Yeah.
Go up early. Go up at like 8:30, 9 o'clock first thing. Make a couple of runs. Be done by 11. It's starting to get busy. I know both mountains are trying very hard to get as much terrain open as possible, but Vail and Beaver Creek, for good reason, are very popular results, especially with the families, oftentimes with newer skiers and riders,
yes.
not the veterans that are getting those million miles. We got plenty of season coming up. You know what my favorite day of the Christmas holiday is?
New Year's January. Day.
No, I like that one. Usually, yeah. I think I'm working this year. I like January 5th.
Yeah.
January 5th, 6th.
Yeah.
Actually, let me check my calendar real quick on what my favorite day is. My favorite day this year, actually, Tricia, it would be January 8th.
8th,
because
okay.
that is the Saturday, Sunday. And to go all out on it, truly, January 10th.
Yeah.
Because we get
yeah.
through the holidays. Our guests have the best time ever. We just give them group hugs if we could. And we're going to talk about masks, you know, to mask mandate or not. Today, by the way, the temperatures, Tricia, I'm calling for a mask. It is cold up here.
yes, your balaclava then, face mask.
Yeah, it is chilly. But as we go through, we have that first week and then everyone's celebrating, you know, New Year's. Let's get past that first week and then let's all of us as Eagle County locals kumbaya at the mid-mountain area
yeah.
and celebrate. Because then we get that little bit of a break before the beginning of February.
Yeah, and you know what? I think, Ken, a lot of people are used to having the whole mountain open. You know, 5,000 acres yeah. over on Vail and the new expansion over at Beaver Creek. Not going to happen. You know, it just isn't happening. So, and then there were some rumors that, oh, they're going to open the back bowls. And I'm like, have you been up there? Mm. You know, so.
I know. Yeah. They're trying.
Yeah, they're trying. Just, oh, yes.
Yeah. And we both know. You and I have worked for the resort forever. And I mean, how hard they're trying. You know what's amazing this year is their snowmaking.
The
groomers.
Yeah. Like, it's like night and day. Just like when we opened up Vail opening day, you're at the base and you're like, how could they open? You go up there and it looks like yeah. mid-January. So it's, yeah, kudos to the teams that have been making it happen and everything. But yeah, you are going to be waiting in lift lines longer. So have the patience, have the wherewithal. We're telling you, the lines are longer than you're used to. So you heard it here first. So, all right, we've got a couple of chatters. All right, Eddie Shipstad, good morning, Vail Daily Live. We're excited to come and perform the Ice Spectacular on this Thursday. And yes, I'm going to this, Ken. I'm going to be sitting on the ice. I'm so excited. So
yeah.
all these, yeah, no, at the Dobson Ice Arena.
Oh,
so the Ice Spectacular, nice. And they're bringing in Olympians, you know, worlds, internationals, all the top skaters are coming here for this. So Eddie Shipstad, he runs that whole program. So he said hello. So that's on Thursday.
We have such amazing skaters that come through here, whether it be locals, Olympians. Tricia, at one time, this will be a controversial name. It was like 20 years ago. I used to work right here at the Gorsuch store, and Tanya Harding. Remember her? Club hand. Saw her ice skate here. That woman is amazing.
Oh, I know.
I loved her movie, I, Tanya. That was interesting. I had no idea. Her mother was hanging out here. She skated here. Unreal.
I know. You know what? And if you go over to the sculptures there, Paul Wiley, he's one of the bronze statues right by the rink. Yeah, right on that side.
I might be blocking it by the viewers, but right here are the two statues.
Yeah.
This is the Black Family Ice Rink. This is a really fun place to come build memories. And Tricia, you know, all the time we kind of say, hey, you're at Vail or hey, you're at Beaver Creek. Mix it up. If you're looking for something to do, you're staying at Vail, come on over. You can park down at the base or, you know, get your hour of free parking up here if you could fit everything in by then, which I doubt. But come up here, come ice skating. If you're in Vail, they have the ice skating rinks at the Arabella Vail Square and Solaris. Ice skating builds memories, and it also turns you into a human highlight reel, Trisha, because there's no telling what the old sea legs are going to do.
Oh, I know, I know. Yeah, yeah. If you're like Ken and I, it's a humbling experience. Now, if you're like Charlie, it's art on ice. It's just amazing to watch her go out there. But okay, all right, Ken, we've got to take a break. I know we got a busy show. I'm excited to hear what Olympian Jake Pates has to say about his new foundation and concussions. Very hot topic in the sports world.
Which, right, Trisha, speaking of ice skating for you.
Yeah,
and I
know. We need the help.
I've got to go run and grab a microphone, and I'm going to blaze over to Hyatt real quick. But for locals or visitors, this is a really good one. I follow Jake on social media, and then I spoke with him last night after dinner about his interview today. This is very near and dear to him, and it's very important. It's not just about athletes that get concussions. It's protecting the brain. It's about keeping it healthy. And Jake has a lot of insight and a program. We're going to find out more what this Olympian and local has been up to help lives.
Yep, and that event is tonight. Okay, thanks, Ken. Yep, we're going to take it to a break. And before we do, hey, we saw the chat. So if you want to chat with us, you can do so. We're on Facebook and YouTube. So when we're live, you can chat with us during the live show. And we'll be live till about 8:30 or so daily, 7:30 to 8:30. Now, if you don't catch us then, we are available on demand all day long on Roku, on Amazon Fire, Apple TV. We're also a podcast on Spotify. And we're on channel 17 in the Vail Valley. That is Outside Television. We're so excited to be associated with them. In fact, today is the Michaela Schifrin docu-series. It's a documentary about Michaela, who, when she's not racing around the world, she lives in Edwards in her beautiful home that's been showcased on the Today Show and all sorts of other magazine publications. But Michaela has a very special documentary series that Outside TV Outside Plus is starting today. So if you want to find out more, go to their website and find out how you can become an Outside Plus member. And this is a 5-part series, so you can really learn a lot. And they're going to kind of reveal it, the two episodes, episode 1 and 2 now. And then through January and February, just leading up to the Olympics, they'll reveal episode 3, 4, and 5. So really good insights to get into Michaela's world, especially after her father died and everything she went through with that. So if you're interested in Michaela Schifrin, that's a good way to go with Outside TV. But okay, now we're going to take it to a break. And when we come back, we're going to give you headlines, traffic, weather, and more. A good night's sleep can be harder to achieve at altitude. Altitude Control Technologies whole room oxygenation system scientifically simulates a lower altitude, no matter how high your mountain home may be. Increased oxygen levels facilitate better sleep and help to alleviate fatigue. The result is more energy, better mood, clarity of mind, and recovery from exercise. Contact Altitude Control Technology for a free consultation and start sleeping better after one night in your oxygenated room. Is your marketplace for locally produced products like seasonal organic produce, meats, eggs, dairy, breads, flowers, Nep nectars, and more. It's the holidays, and Nep Harvest can help you with all the ingredients to make your holiday meals delicious. Or we have take-and-bake meals if you're in a rush. Nep Harvest has fabulous gift ideas for everyone on your gift list. Nep Harvest, your indoor farmer's market, opens 7 days a week in Eagle Ranch. All right, welcome back to Vail Daily Live. We're looking at the daily today. It is the shortest day of the year. Winter solstice begins later on this morning, Tuesday the 21st. And we're going to let you know what made headlines and what's on the cover of today's Vail Daily. Look at that gorgeous shot, a beautiful, iconic building with the clock tower, the decorations. That's actually the Gorsuch store and Fall Line restaurant right on Bridge Street. looking good and all dolled up for the holidays. You can find that on today's cover of today's paper. But in headlines, surge protection kit. As Omicron variant drives fastest surge yet, top Vail health official says vaccines, masks, and prioritizing physical and mental health is critical. More on this on page A3. Also in today's paper, asking for a seat at the table. Historically excluded from Colorado River policy, tribes want a say in how dwindling resource is used. More on this on page A2. Also in today's paper, we're looking at sports. Thomas Walsh, born and raised here, he podiums in San Moritz, and Radamus nabs another top 10 in Alta Badia. Walsh also finished fourth in GS on Friday and fifth in GS on Saturday. He is vying for the Paralympic team. Just great to hear how well he's doing, as well as River Radamus. And Ski and Snowboard Club Vail announces community-based events. The Vail Cup, Nordic Town Series, and Family Fun Days are focused on opening up winter sports to everyone in the community. You can learn more of that on page A34 and how you can get involved with some of those races. And then in Preps Roundup, holiday competitions. Eagle Valley contends 6 basketball games and 1 Nordic ski race, and Battle Mountain plays 3 games as well, all before the holiday break. So it's going to be a very busy week in prep sports. So that's a look at the Vail Daily. Pick up your copy. You can grab them for free in newspaper dispensers from East Vail all the way down to Gypsum, or go online. You can get breaking news alerts, traffic alerts, and more by subscribing. VailDaily.com for more info. And speaking of traffic, let's see what it's looking like out there. Probably pretty good right now because we're seeing those nice dry roads. Keep in mind, there are some shady areas that really never lose their ice. And then there's areas that see sun during the day. It melts, it freezes overnight. So be careful, especially around places like Dow Junction. That's in the lower right-hand side of your screen. Or if you're traveling over Vail Pass, going through Summit County, maybe on your way to Denver, Frisco, Officer's Gulch, between Frisco and Copper, always kind of an area to keep your eye out for some of that black ice. But now our roads could change as we approach the weekend. We are going to have a lot of holiday traffic, for one, but with the snow that's predicted to come in, we could see that really alter the roads on Friday, Christmas Eve day, and then on Saturday, Christmas Eve. So some things to consider. Even Sunday, we could see some lingering storms roll on through. But let's take it out to Ken Hovey. He's standing by up at Beaver Creek, and he's been checking out. Oh, you found some cookies? Oh, you found the fireplaces. That's good.
Yes. Yeah. This is one of the nice amenities that to share with viewers. We talk about skiing and riding all the time. You know, if you're on the mountain or snowshoeing, it's nice just to come up and check things out, right? You could just come up, hang out, watch all the activities, grab a cup of coffee, sit by the fire pits that are going, bring some s'mores, take some photographs, and of course, watch what goes on the mountain.
Ken, looking at those couches, I mean, you could take a nap up there. They're so plush. I love them.
I'm sure after a solid après showing, some humans have had to lounge on those for a while waiting for their friends to carry them home or to earth surf it. Hey. It is a little bit chilly up. Yeah, go ahead.
Oh, Ken, you know, right behind you, we got the Hay Meadow Express. And did you realize that when you go to the top of that gondola, there's an ice cream shop up there?
What?
Yes. So I think a lot of people don't know about this because I think it debuted in the 2019-2020 season. And then we know what happened after that. You know, the world all kind of got crazy. So I don't think people really know that you can just go up there and get ice cream.
Yes, I did not know that either. But Tricia, you're talking to someone that most recently on the internet, like 2 days ago, got fat shamed and called chubby.
Oh, no way.
Somebody was hurtful. Something bad happened to them when they were a kid, that I was the chubby guy. So,
oh my.
There's that.
Hey, you're not going to go.
I love ice cream.
You're not going to go manorexic on us again, are you? Remember when you were on that diet? No. Oh, my.
Yeah, okay. The 60-pound weight loss, that's not going to happen. I love ice cream. That sounds like a good one. I'd go for a milkshake right now if they were open. Yeah. Trisha, I wanted to share the Arabelle. Can we bring that video up?
Oh, yeah.
About Beaver Creek. Yeah, this is the scene over there this past weekend for our viewers. Really getting into the festive spirit, going up on the mountain. Trisha and I did mention that it's starting to get busy on the mountain, but if you go early, which this is, Trisha, it's rather nice. This is another great spot to stop by and start holiday tradition.
You know what? We should rank the trees. You know, like, so the Hyatt's got a really cool tree. Arabelle's got a really cool tree. You know, if you've been to the Velar, and they've got a performance tonight with the Five Browns, they've got an awesome tree, too. So we could, like, have a tree contest or something.
This is, and as you mentioned, Trisha, some of the limited terrain in Game Creek. I do like that idea. I mean, they all look so beautiful throughout the valley. It is very festive here. But, you know, one of my favorite places, just cruising along the top. Trisha, this video was early in the day when it was still quiet. And that's why I encourage people to do that. Go up, ride a little bit earlier, and take the afternoon off, and then come sit by a fire pit. And all of that footage, most of it was shot yesterday, and that snow shot was from that last snowstorm. So it's all pretty recent.
Okay. Yeah, no, it definitely is. And you know what? Just we've talked about snowmaking and how different it is. I mean, looking behind you, it looks great. I mean, the coverage is great from where they've been making snow and everything. And I know we've mentioned that they're trying to open up more terrain as soon as they can. They did open up Bachelor Gulch Chairlift, lift number 16. Sawbuck is what you can use to ski down. Hey, but Ken, so I was up there at the top of 16 and I was looking out from Sawbuck, and I could see the new lifts. I could see those two new lifts in the McCoy expansion. And I was about to take a picture, and then right then and there, my phone died. Like, it got cold all day. So I was like, oh, shoot, I can't even take the picture.
Yeah, that's usually it. I haven't seen them. I mean, so many of us have thought about that area, you know, over the years. I can remember when I first moved here, I'm going on 30 years, lived at the Tarns, and we knew this area that no one knew about. And it's now where Bachelor Gulch is and the Ritz, right? Arrowhead used to be its own ski resort, its own like mom and pop operation. Then there was Beaver Creek, and behind the Tarns was this awesome spot. And now that is what is Bachelor Gulch. Well, now the question is, Trisha, both those areas are open. It's going to be, when can we ski between the two? I wonder if you can do that yet. Do you think?
I know.
Well, I don't know that. I'm not going to say you can. I think you probably still have to bus it, but I know that's one that they'll work on. Big news up here, though, that we'll talk to Rachel about. Chocolate chip cookies are back.
Oh, yeah. Chocolate chip cookies are back. And you know what else is back? Thursday Night Lights. Okay, so this is the glow stick ski down that they do on Thursdays. And now you need to be a rider that can handle being in the dark. Okay, so you got to be level 5 skier or snowboarder. You take that Hay Meadow Express up. And then, right behind you. And then, Ken, have you ever done this? Have you ever done this with your kids? It's really fun to do. Okay, yep. So on Thursday nights, you'll be like, wow, do they have night skiing? Not really. We just have one run, but you can do it. It's for free. You get your glow sticks, you stand in line, and then you head on up. And then they go down and they kind of end in front of the Powder 8 Kitchen and Tap, which is a little bit more to the west of you. And but Ken, this is really fun. And it just started last week. It's going all the way through the end of March. And now, you know, it's going to get dark so early that we can do this pretty early. So stop by ski school and they'll let you know the times because they fluctuate throughout the year. But
Patricia, today I was excited when I heard you say this. You know, this is breaking news. It's winter solstice.
Yeah.
The days now that much at a time get longer.
Yes.
They're not getting shorter anymore.
I know.
Reason to rejoice in my book.
I know. It is for me too. And, you know, and minute by minute. And Ken, we do want to remind people, lifts open at 8:30 over in Vail now. So 8:30 at Vail and then 9 o'clock at Beaver Creek. Beaver Creek will stay 9 to 4 pretty much throughout the whole season. And then 8:30 to, what do you got going on over there? Oh, yeah. Hey, and you know what? And don't bring your dogs up on the mountain. Nope.
You need to see it again?
Yeah. No uphill access.
Yeah. I'll put that back up.
Follow the rules or you're going to ruin it for the rest of us.
And you know what? We're going to share why quickly, Trisha. People still do it, though, right? They're out there uphilling. Trisha, you mentioned, though, and we'll share that there is an area you're allowed to do it right now. Uphill access policy, it is prohibited during operating hours. uphill access. Get your pens. You call this number. I think this is our security office, 754-5907. One more time, 754-5907. Visit the website. Here's the rules. Uphill travel only allowed. Designated routes for both ascending and descending. Dogs are prohibited, as you mentioned, and no sledding at any time. Do you know, Tricia? Yeah. It is because there are operations going on up there. There are snowmobiles and snowmobiles and winch cats and this and that and all these things. And they're getting the mountain all perfectly prepared for you. And they're, you know, you're not their primary concern. You are their concern, right? I'm not going to say you're not their primary concern. They are looking out for your safety, but they're working. And
they're trying to get a job done. You
know, trying to get a job done. So as of right now with limited terrain, it is prohibited during operating hours, but give them a call. It says no bikes on here. I guarantee you we're going to have some yahoos on e-bikes with monster tires, like dirt biking up the mountain at some point. So don't do that either, guys. I know it's tempting, especially after a few beverages, but bad call.
Bad idea. Not safe. Bad idea, jeans. Okay, cool.
Bad
idea,
jeans.
All right. Hey, let's go to commercial break. I know you got to go find Olympian Jake Pates. We're excited about that. So we're going to let you go and do that. But so stay with us. More VDL is coming your way.
In the extraordinary, we're free to discover more together. All pass prices reduced 20%. Prices go up November 21st, so purchase yours now.
Welcome to the club.
What's going on?
Get your arms up.
Hours of operation, whenever you need to feel good. The club has no dress code.
You got this.
No rules of decorum. Pets are allowed.
Now we're squad jumping up a storm.
Quick.
You don't have to show your card at the door.
Breathe naturally.
There is no door to the club. There is no ceiling. And if you have 10 minutes.
Come on.
20.
Oh,
30.
Yes.
And if you're wearing one of these, let's go.
Take a walk on the wild side.
She told me to walk this way. She told me to.
Boots are made for walking, and that's just what they'll do. One of these days, these boots are gonna walk all over you.
We are here at the Solaris Ice Rink in Vail Village, and joining me now we have Eddie Shipstad, and he's with the Vail Skating Festival, and we have a very special show coming up for the holidays. This will be over at Dobson. I know you do the outdoor shows at Solaris and the Arabelle Ice Rink, but this will be indoors, and it's your big show.
It is. It's a 90-minute production. Amazing skating. We call it high energy for 90 minutes. We love skating in Vail. The crowd is always pumped up. We have two different types of seating. We've got Ane seating for $40, and we have bleacher seating for $20.
Well, that's so cool. You can be on the ice.
Like, you are on the ice. You can physically feel the skaters, like, land on the ice. You can feel it in your seat. It's amazing.
So just the perspective and everything to
absolutely
be right there.
Yeah,
okay, cool.
Incredible.
And who are your skaters? Who are
we have
see?
Starring is Mariah Nagasu. She's 2018 Olympic medalist. She is the first U.S. woman to ever hit a triple axel at the Olympic Games. She's incredible. What a great performer. We have Vaughn Chipier from Canada, who's our high-flying acrobatic skater. He has some of the biggest backflips I've ever seen on ice. And then we have a bunch of skaters this year that are going for the Olympic team. They'll be competing in Nashville in 2 weeks. And they're performing their short programs. Our first half of the show, many of them are competing, are skating programs that they've done for 100 times this year, and they're performing them here in Vail.
Wow, it's like a sneak preview of what's going to be happening later on with the Olympics. Yeah. And then plus, you know, that holiday theme and everything.
Absolutely.
Too. And
we have something for everybody. We're very proud this year. We have every discipline in our show. We have single skaters, male and female. We have great pair teams. We have a great dance team who I think we'll see 4 years from now in the Olympic Games. And then we have a synchronized skating team. So we have every aspect of our sport of figure skating in this show.
Okay, and we can get our tickets in advance if we want.
Absolutely. VailSkateFest.com is where you want to get your tickets now. Everything will be will call. But you can get them at the door the day of the show. We'll be there as early as 8 o'clock in the morning selling tickets. Everything is general admission, but the on-ice seats, you want to get there a little early to get your best spot.
All right. And then at the door the day of, in case, we're just getting to town or anything. But okay. So VailSkateFest.com.
Yep.
Eddie, thanks so much for bringing exciting event and a holiday tradition to the Vail Valley.
Awesome. Thanks, Trisha.
This Weather and Mountain Report is brought to you by Carrots Jewelers, creating heirlooms for over 50 years.
All right, I want to give you a quick look at the weather right now. We're seeing temperatures pretty balmy compared to what they've been the last couple of days. And isn't it funny? We can call 19 balmy, but it was in the single digits earlier this week. But today we'll see temperatures rise into the upper 30s, plenty of sunshine. We're looking at a live look. You see the West Vail roundabouts, I-70, the traffic's moving quite swimmingly right now. You can see just the sun starting to hit the higher peaks there before it'll hit the valley floor. And that's one of the reasons why I have a kind of an inversion. Sometimes we'll have warmer temperatures in Vail and cooler temperatures as you go down valley into Eagle, that sort of thing. But our overnight low back down to the teens, and then tomorrow we'll be right in the upper 30s, low 40s, and we'll also see an increased chance of clouds throughout the day. And then Thursday we start to see the rain showers, snow showers, depending on the temperature, depending on what elevation you're at. Mountain snow, valley rain could be the possibility there. And according to opensnow.com, we could possibly see 2 inches on Thursday in Vail, 2 over at Beaver Creek, 10 inches on Friday the 24th in Beaver Creek, 9 over at Vail, 4 at Beaver Creek for Saturday the 25th, Christmas Day, and 4 over in Vail. So looking pretty promising for at least some sort of accumulation. Hopefully we'll see all that come to fruition and have a very, very white Christmas. But traveling at that point will be a little bit difficult. So just keep that in mind if you have friends coming into town, people coming to the Eagle Airport, the Denver Airport, and they might be slowed down a little bit due to traffic. Terrain-wise, Mountain Report, no new snow to report in the last 24 hours, but we did open up a bit more terrain last week on Vail Mountain. Now we have portions of Game Creek Bowl open for you. So lift number 7, which will be enhanced to a 6-passenger chairlift next season. They're a 4-pack right now. They have Lost Boy, Dealer's Choice, Woods, that kind of thing open. All the northern-facing slopes are fine. But Uzo, Faro, those are still closed because they're south-facing, and they just haven't received as much snow, and the snow has melted when we had our 50-degree temperatures in November. So just a little tip for you. And keep in mind, the lift lines are a little long these days because we do have limited terrain. So just have patience. Enjoy the company you're with, and keep in mind they're loading the chairlifts to full capacity, so they're getting those people up there. And then over at Beaver Creek, they did open up chair number 16. This is the Bachelor Gulch Express, taking you from the Ritz-Carlton and the beautiful homes in that area up. They just have Sawbuck open for you right now, but at least it gives you somewhere to go. So Beaver Creek also has the upper greens open. In case you're a beginner, try to stay on a train that's appropriate for you, and you can always download at the end of the day if you're tired or if you don't have the skill level to get you down the runs that'll take you to the base. It's highly recommended that you download at the end of the day. But right now, I want to let you know about the lens of the day. This is brought to you by the Eyepieces of Vail. We have plenty of locations in Lion's Head, Vail Village, top of Bridge Street, Beaver Creek as well. And I thought I'd bring out the Anon. This is the WM1. And the cool thing about this is all the magnet technology that's going on here. First of all, this is a removable little neck gaiter. So you could take it, you could put it in the wash, whatever, and then on the colder days, wear it. It's got a nice little breathable fabric area for your mouth, and you won't get fogged up, which is pretty unbelievable, the technology that's here. And then Anon does a great job with magnets and their lenses. So this is a lighter lens. You've got the darker lens for the sunny days, so you can bring the lenses with you. Maybe a day like Wednesday, where it's going to be sunny in the morning and then cloudy in the afternoon, you can just swap it out easily on the chairlift. So I love this. I love the magnetic face mask. And then they use this perceived lens technology, which increases contrast and definition in flat light conditions. And there's an anti-fog coating inside these lenses as well. So if you're looking for a gift idea for someone, maybe that skier, snowboarder in your life that has trouble with their goggles, maybe get them a new pair. And then also, don't forget, they do prescriptions. So a lot of these goggles come with different inserts or different technology that allows you to see just as well as you would if you had your glasses or your contacts in. So kind of a good idea. So that's a look at your lens of the day. Right now, we're going to go out to Ken Hovey. He's standing by in Beaver Creek. And I think he's got Jake with him, Jake Pates, Olympian, who's changing his focus to teach people about concussions and brain healing. So let's take it out to the Beav. Oh, we can't hear Ken. Hold on a second. We're gonna get to that in just a second. But so what Jake Pates is doing is he has his happyhealthybrainfoundation.org. It's a brand new nonprofit started in 2020. And Jake himself, an Olympian, X Games athlete, he's competed all over the world. He's from Eagle. We watched him grow up here, do the Burton US Open, everything. But he suffered a concussion. And what he's trying to do is to create more of a baseline so athletes and even just regular people know what's going on with their brain, and then also so they can find out what happens and when to go back to sport. A lot of times you're like, I'm fine, I feel fine, it'll be no problem. But your brain isn't quite healed yet. So he's working hard, and he's working with experts around the nation and technology that's world class to really help devise that. So we'll get to that interview. In Emma, we're going to go to Michaela first. Okay. I was telling you earlier about the Michaela Schifrin documentary series that is being released today on Outside Plus. This is a special, more subscription-based with Outside TV and the Outside magazine. So Michaela has this five-part series. We're going to show you a trailer right now so you can learn a little bit more about this.
Everyone, let's stand up for two-time Olympic champion.
Some domination from Michaela Schifrin.
Six-time world champion.
Schifrin shows the rest of the world why she is the queen of the slalom.
When Michaela is on, there's nobody that can touch her.
We had a ton of momentum the last 4.5 years prior to the tragedy. She had won the overall each year, as well as some discipline titles, and everything stopped.
It's hard to describe in just a few words, but it was like this invisible blanket was just covering me and my whole world, and it was just dimmer.
You don't heal from losing someone that you love that much. You get to the other side.
Ooh, right out of the gate, Doug. Here we go.
Just getting back to consistently putting down great performances is what our goal is.
We're now less than 100 days from the start of the games, and trust me.
But you do have big goals. What are they?
The biggest competitor to Michaela is Michaela. Us mere mortals, we can't even begin to like appreciate how that works.
I'm very excited to race tomorrow. Maybe a little jittery, but let's do this.
Welcome back to VDL. Sorry for the technical difficulties earlier. Joining me once again, Jake Pates. A lot of us know him as an Eagle County local, but so many around the world recognize him more for his social media prowess on a snowboard. And also, he's an Olympian. Good to see you this morning.
Good to be here, Ken. Thanks so much.
Makes me so happy to see you. Jake and I go way back. Taught my kids how to skateboard back in the day. Watch you grow up through the ranks and then to perform at the Olympics. What's it like to be home?
So good to be back. It's been a while since then, and just you know, living life and doing my thing. So
yeah, I love watching you ride. It's got to be interesting. It seems like you've taken a little bit of a step back from competitive snowboarding, but I see you and your brother out there all the time. Do people just trip out when they see you ride like with normal people. It's like when Olympic skiers go skiing on the slopes. I mean, they're like, who is that guy?
I don't know if I get that as much, but man, yeah, it's been fun to just kind of, you know, go out for fun with my brother. We do a lot of filming, and he's a great guy as well.
And it, you guys make a great team. Before we go into what Jake is up to now, I wanted to show some footage. This is from, which Olympics is this?
This is the 2018 Pyeongchang in South Korea.
And I remember watching this with my family, and you were in the finals. I think it came down to 10. Sean White was there. Tal, you went after one of the Japanese rider that took a massive crash.
Yeah, that was, I was actually rewatching that last night. There was two people ahead of me that fell. Yuto broke his femur in half, and then also Yuri Podlachka, he ended up having a really bad head injury. So they kind of paused everything for a while, and that was obviously a little intimidating. So
I was up at like 11 o'clock at night, I think it was, on here in the States, and we do have some footage of Jake riding in that, but it's going to bring me to what I want to talk about with you now. I mean, it was such a horrific crash. Here you are, you're about to drop into what is potentially going to be a gold medal round, and when it goes down, this accident occurs, and then it occurs to you, injuries in sports, especially head injuries, they're frequent.
Right. Yeah. So much, especially half pipe, is, you know, just a small margin of error. And you know, anything can happen. So, careful out there. That's for sure.
And this is, you know, some of the rides. And if it's, is this you on this ride right here?
That's Ben Ferguson, actually.
Okay. And I've met Ben over in Summit County, but regardless of which clips we get to, that's the competition that you are in. Congratulations, by the way. Like,
thank you.
My kids all gather around like, go Jake, and then we saw that crash and we're like, oh my gosh, man. I mean, it's like gladiators, Viking style up there, and the material that you land on can be as hard as concrete.
Right. Yeah, it's so hard. It's just, you know, solid ice basically, and a lot of the time we're, you know, 15-20 feet above the top of the deck there, and there's another 22 feet down to the flat bottom of the half pipe. So definitely dangerous, but fun as well. So.
I love watching this. Take us through this ride.
Yeah, so this is actually Dew Tour 2017. This was the that me and the Olympic team, I ended up winning this car, which I was so happy and lucky to just happen. So
perfect. Now, this is what I wanted to come to now, is to talk about what you're doing. We look at the sports, we know that we live in an area that people are constantly pushing the envelope, whether it be kayaking or climbing or just driving down. Head injuries can impact you at any given moment.
Right. And, you know, I am someone who's experienced that firsthand. I've had a lot of head injuries, never really had the opportunity to objectively assess my recovery coming back. So I started a foundation, it's called Head Foundation, March 20. And our mission is to basically modernize the standard of concussion management for athletes. We're holding a fundraiser and a
Oh, shoot, we're losing their audio on that. Oh, but I wanted to hear what Jake had to say. But basically, he's talking about the fundraiser that'll be held tonight. This will be at the Vail Christian High School. It's going to open up at 5:15 and going to go all the way till 7:30. They're going to have some appetizers, silent auction to help raise money for this Happy Healthy Brain Foundation. And then what's going to be amazing is the guest speakers. So, you know, and Jake will be a part of this. And they're honored and super excited to welcome a special guest, Dr. Syed Assad. And he is just amazing. He specializes in traumatic brain injuries, and we're really glad to have him in town for this event. And Vail Christian High School has graciously donated their facilities to this. So, and this is important for anyone. Like Ken was saying, even if you're just a weekend warrior, maybe you're a kayaker or a mountain biker, or, okay, are we back? Okay, here we go. Hey, we guys, we got you. Yeah, we can hear you. Hey, here you go, Ken. Yeah, there we go.
I'll be talking back. Good to see you, Tricia. Welcome back. I just wanted to wrap things up with Jake. We're going to put this segment together, but it is such an important subject. If the microphone dropped off there, we're talking about his program, which is Happy Healthy Brain.
Yep.
And we are basically at the point right now of speaking about how these can impact you and also about what you can do, to help people that are going through these and where you can learn more.
Right. So we started a foundation, Happy Healthy Brain Foundation, and we're also holding an event for concussion education and awareness called Return to Play, the missing piece of the concussion puzzle. And yeah, we're basically trying to create awareness and educate parents and athletes on the seriousness of concussions and how we can utilize new objective technologies to ensure safe return to play practice.
And tell me also, what are the technologies that you use?
So we're using an affordable EEG brain scanning device. So basically, this really great technology made easy to use, made portable, and get a base through their scans through the progress, the process of their brain, contact your brain, make sure that the brain is healthy and the brain is good.
So, Kiwi, once you get back to play and doing your sports, injecting your brain once again, heal from. But more about the program taking place tonight at Vail Christian, when and where?
Yes.
I guess I should ask where and or when and what can people expect?
Yeah, exactly. So you guys can expect fun and we're really trying to bring awareness to this whole thing. This going to be food. Our partner, who's TBI board certified, about 100 country, cover our keynote event, since it's serious and the technologized.
This well, man, I was proud of the Olympics and just to be all around.
All right, you know what? We apologize for the technical difficulties of that. But once again, if you want to learn more, and like I was saying earlier, if, you know, parents, this is a great thing to know for your kids. Because really, when I was talking to Jake yesterday about this, he said a lot of times your brain will adapt to whatever it needs to do before it actually is healed. So a lot of times, athletes, people will get back into their sport, do whatever they want to do because they want to do it. And they feel okay, but really, scientifically, their brain isn't quite healed. So to know the difference and to just educate yourself about this, and like I said, it's not just for athletes and high school football and soccer and everybody. It's for everybody. So you could stop by once again 5:15 tonight over at the Vail Christian High School campus all the way till 7:30 this evening. So if you make a donation, that's your entry. Right now, we're going to check in with Skea, a great brand here in the Valley.
Hi, I'm Charlie Kennedy with Vail Daily Live, and I'm so excited. I'm here with Diane Boyer, and she is from Skea, which is a Vail-based ski company. And Diane, tell us a bit about Skea.
Oh, it's so nice to meet you, Charlie. Skea is a company that started in 1972.
Wow.
And I was a little girl, not that little, but little enough, and started working with my parents. And we were based in the East, and we skied in Vermont at that point. And then we moved to Vail little by little during the next few years. And we are a ladies-specific ski company.
Yes, that's
so
right.
We make ladies or women's.
Women's.
And girls' ski clothing. And we really feel, as women skiers and snowboarders, we know what works and how to look pretty but still stay warm and dry and functional when you're skiing. So it's super fun. I love what I do. We have a tagline, follow your passion. And skiing is one of my passions. And being happy and cheerful when you're skiing, I think, is such an important thing. I mean, we should all live life in that manner.
I mean, you're just fabulous. And the ski suit you're actually wearing right now, tell us about this particular print, because I mean, it makes me feel happy looking at
it. Oh, you're so sweet. This is our Aloha print, and this jacket has touches of the Aloha print, but it's all over my pants. And it's a print done for us by a German artist, Catherine Greisiger. And I actually have a video of her painting this watercolor painting.
Oh my.
And it's
goodness.
Super cool. So it's just exclusive to Skea for this season. And then we have all sorts of colors that coordinate with it, whether it's a pink or a turquoise or a lilac.
Oh.
And so you could have a print pant and a solid jacket, or you could have a solid pant and a print jacket.
Oh,
it's really
the
fun.
Options. I mean, it's so stunning. It's beautiful. And you're right. It's fashionable and functional.
Yes.
Too.
What's really fun is everything's waterproof, stretch, breathable.
Okay.
The pants have a stretch thinsulate lining. And then the jacket, this jacket actually is a stretch and thinsulate insulated jacket.
Oh.
The jacket you're wearing, for example, is downfilled. So
okay.
We do all different things. But what's nice about Skea is we say we don't dress hangers, we dress women. So we take great concern to the woman's figure and making sure
wow.
that it's nipped in the right place and has room for her bosom and has room for her derriere. And
yes.
And yet nice what we call thummy cuffs to
love those.
To keep you warm.
I love those about these jackets.
Yes,
yeah.
Exactly. And inside your gloves.
Yeah.
This one has an inner little fur collar that is super warm and cozy, and it also protects the jacket from makeup.
Okay.
And it's washable, and it's faux fur.
You really have thought through these designs.
Yeah.
I mean, it's so relatable, and they're so perfect. So where can we find you guys located?
In our local area in the Vail Valley, we're at Christie Sports.
Okay.
We're at Peppy Sports. And we are at Beaver Creek Sports as well. Hopefully this year, again, we'll be back in the Vail Sports system. And we are also available online at skealimited.com. And it's really fun. I mean, it's a great brand, and it works, and it lasts forever. I mean, we saw a friend in the lift line who
yes.
had her daughter's jacket from 10 years ago on. And she
amazing.
Looked great. She
I
looked
mean,
great.
You look great. It's fashion. It's function. It's beautiful. Thank you so much, Diane.
You're so
I mean,
welcome.
It's the pink fur for me.
Oh,
so
it's all about
go
the fur.
And check
isn't
it
that
out.
Fun?
It's amazing. So that is Skea with Diane Boyer.
It's winter and we are back. VDL streams everywhere.
On the mountain, off the mountain.
On every screen.
On Facebook, YouTube.
On Roku, Amazon Fire, Apple TV, and Spotify.
And now, we're on Outside TV 17.
Live and on demand, 7 days a week.
Club One is a pivotal part of the Vail lifestyle, with spacious lockers to store all your gear in a ski-in, ski-out location. Club One is your mountain headquarters, stacked with club amenities and members-only perks. Club One, we're the locals' locker.
In the extraordinary, we're free to discover more together. All pass prices reduced 20%. Prices go up November 21st, so purchase yours now.
Maui Jim sunglasses were born on the beaches of Hawaii, designed to respond to the bright sun and harsh glare of the islands, all while enhancing the view. After 30 years, we're still independently owned, and the free-thinking Hawaiian spirit that first inspired us is still a part of everything we do. Our Polarized Plus 2 lenses not only protect eyes from harmful rays, they also make colors more vivid and contrast crisper. Try on a pair and see for yourself. The view is better from here.
This weather and mountain report is brought to you by Live Sotheby's International Realty, Colorado's leading real estate firm. Contact their Vail Valley broker professionals today to help you live the life you love.
All right, I want to give you some weather details right now. We're starting out in the 20s, and we'll be reaching into the upper 30s by later on today. What it feels like out there, still kind of like almost single digits, just 10 degrees, but we'll see the sun rise up a little higher in the sky. And then overnight lows will be back down into the teens. And then for tomorrow, we'll see a little bit of clouds building as we approach our weekend storm. And it is the winter solstice today, the shortest day of the year in the northern hemisphere, the longest day of the year in the southern hemisphere. I think I heard right around 8:59 this morning is when winter officially begins. We say goodbye to fall, and the daylight hours now going forward, we start getting a little bit longer after today. So that's something to look forward to. But this big storm is what we have looked forward to as well. So according to opensnow.com, the Joel Gratz and the gang over there, they're saying that maybe on Thursday we could get about 2 inches of new snow. over at Beaver Creek, and then 10 inches new on Friday the 24th, kind of the biggest day of the storm, and then tapering off Saturday into Sunday. And then for Vail, maybe about 9 inches new and 4 on Saturday, another 5 on Sunday. So hopefully this storm will materialize and bring us some well-needed snowfall to the mountains of Vail and Beaver Creek. I want to remind you that we still have limited terrain over on Vail and Beaver Creek Mountain. A lot of times we have the back bowls open by now and everything. Not the case this year. They did open kind of one of the side bowls, if you will. Game Creek Bowl was just opened last week, lift number 7, but only portions of it. The runs that face more north, such as Northwoods, Lost Boy, Woods, Dealer's Choice, those are open, but runs like Uzo, Faro, not open yet because they're more south-facing. So keep that in mind when you're planning your day. And do expect to find lift lines. And they are loading the lifts to full capacity as of what we've seen the last couple of weeks. So they're trying to get up there as soon as they can. Over at Beaver Creek, we did open Bachelor Gulch Express, lift number 16. And that takes you to Sawbuck, and that'll bring you back down to the Ritz-Carlton and a lot of the different lodging properties and beautiful homes over in the Bachelor Gulch area. But no new snow to report in the last 24 hours. Vail did open up their lift hours a little bit earlier in the mornings, 8:30 as of last Saturday. Beaver Creek right now is still 9 to 4 p.m. So that's a quick look at your weather and terrain report. Let's check in now with what we've got going on our Vail Live and our chat. Let's see who we've got. I know we talked to Eddie. Rodney was there today. Megan, the Christmas mouse, loving the fire outside. Yes, up at Beaver Creek. I love those fire pits. So that's awesome. So cool. And then James is wondering why locals refer to the lift numbers opposed to names of the lift. You know what? I refer to it both. A lot of times I'll say Centennial Lift or Lift 6. I know that in the newspaper, we usually do the name of the lift and the number that corresponds with it. Eagle Bond Gondola, number 19. A lot of people say, hey, meet me at the top of 11 at 11. So then they just use the lift number and Northwoods. I think it's such a combination of whatever you're used to or whatever you can actually remember. There's quite a few lifts on both mountains. So I think it's just a combination of what people can remember. But thanks for the chat, everyone. And now let's see your photos. Let's see what you've been doing. Oh, there we've got Santa. Santa has confirmed that Archie is on the nice list. So very good. Archie's been a good dog this year. And then, wow, Powabunga, still talking about that. Okay, cool. And then Pow, wow, let's see. I wonder when that was. Probably the last storm from CJ Bevo. And Eagle Veterinary, don't take yourself too seriously on a Monday. Good advice for your Tuesday as well. And the Skea Patrol dogs, getting up there. Look, he's got his little mittens on his paws too. So, all right, there's a couple looks at what we've got going on the slopes and your photos. You can tag us, VDL, Vail Daily Live, Vail Live, tag us, and we'll try to get your photo on the air as well. Don't forget, we've got a couple things going on with Beaver Creek tonight. 5 Browns, they are playing 5 grand pianos. These are 5 siblings, the Brown family, and so we'll have 10 hands, tons of keys. It's going to be a fun night. A little bit of classical music as well as holiday music. Should be a great show this evening at the Villar if you're looking for something to do tonight. Hey, let's take it to a break, and we're going to talk more about Beaver Creek with Ken when we return.
See and be seen with the eyepieces of Vail. View our curated collection of the best eyewear from around the world. Find your favorite brands and be introduced to new lines of eyeglasses, sunglasses, and goggles. See in style with prescription services done in-house at Eyepieces of Vail. Schedule time with one of our optometrists or get a comprehensive digital eye exam. Our on-site laboratory allows you to get your prescription done quickly so you can get back out there. Eyepieces of Vail, the art of vision.
I'm sorry, now I am a The ride of your life is closer than you think. For the first time ever, buy your new car entirely from home with Nissan at Home. Delivered direct from dealer to driveway.
All right, here we go. Miller in motion. What, wait, is that a baby on the field?
It looks like it, Craig.
And the defensive linemen are playing peekaboo. I've never seen anything like that before.
Harris now appears to be burping the baby.
That's a great moment right there.
Ref going to the rule book here.
Well, wait a minute. Harris is off to the races.
We don't need any more trick plays.
Touchdown!
But we could all use more ways to save.
Are you kidding me?
That's got to be a long bus ride home for the defense.
Switch to Geico for more ways to save.
The Ice Spectacular returns to Dobson Ice Arena in Vail on December 23rd. View the amazing ice skating talent from Olympic, World, International, Team USA, and other seasoned professionals, including Mirai Nagasu, 2018 Olympic medalist and U.S. national champion. This 90-minute show will provide high-energy entertainment for the whole family. More information and tickets are available online at vailskatefest.com.
It's winter and we are back.
Snow reports.
Grooming updates.
Road reports.
Party info. Food and fun.
We are VDL.
This Weather and Mountain Report is brought to you by Betteridge. Fine jewelry and watches with exceptional service since 1897, located in Solaris.
All right, one more last weather before we leave you for the day, and then we're going to head out to Ken Hovey. He's got Rachel Levitsky standing by to let us know what's happening at the Beeve this week. But currently, we're looking at 19 degrees in Vail and similar temperatures throughout the valley, and we're going to see the temperature rise into the upper 30s. 37 for your high, but then dropping back down to the teens overnight, especially with these clear skies. Now, tomorrow, we have a chance of clouds starting to build in the afternoon. And then by Thursday, we'll hopefully start to see those snow showers, mainly after 11 a.m. And then for Friday, snow showers likely, mostly cloudy, and the chance of precipitation is 70%. Now, looking at open snows forecast, they're predicting maybe about 2 inches for Vail and Beaver Creek on your Thursday, and then the bulk of the snow will fall from this storm system on Friday into Saturday, and that'll be maybe 10 inches over at Beaver Creek and 9 inches over at Vail, and then 4 on Christmas Day at both resorts. Once again, that's what's predicted right now from open snow, so hopefully we will see that come to fruition, and it looks like we could get a little bit of snow on Sunday as well, the 26th. So do your snow dance, wash your car, whatever you need to do. We need the snow to open up more terrain. And speaking of terrain, we did open up Game Creek Bowl, at least portions of it. Lift number 7, Game Creek Express is open for you, along with runs like Lost Boy, the Dealer's Choice, Woods, all those that face kind of more north versus the southern faces, runs like Uzo and Farrell, they are not open. So just keep that in mind. You can almost just see there's a line. They had the border right down below the chairlift, so you can see where the sun hits the mountain and where the shade remains all throughout the day, especially with the sun so low in the sky. We are in winter solstice today. This is the shortest day of the year on our side here on the northern hemisphere, longest day of the year on the southern side of the hemisphere. We're going to take it out to Ken Hovey. Ken, we did open up Vetcher Gulch Lift for a little terrain report, so we've got that. And you're with Rachel. Hello, everyone. How are you today?
Hi, Trisha. Good to see you.
Hi, good to see you.
Trisha, we're going to save it. We're going to make the viewers wait for just a moment. This is one of those anticipation moments where I can share with you that I promise you we have really great news.
Okay.
But we're not going to tell you quite yet. How's that? Okay. We'll get to some events. And then for the Beaver Creek lovers out there, time to rejoice today.
Okay.
Ellie, good to see you, Rachel.
Good to see you, Ken. Yeah, as Ken said, we've got tons of events going on in Beaver Creek Village this week. So we have cheer presented by Extraordinaire on the 26th.
What is this?
Starting the 26th.
As though Beaver Creek wasn't happy enough.
Oh,
there's an actual
goodness.
Cheer festival.
Cheer festival. So we've got, you know, holiday characters throughout the village. We've got some ice shows. We have live music. There's lots to be excited about. And of course, cookies. My favorite thing about Beaver Creek. It makes the holidays feel joyous and cheerful. And we're so excited to welcome our guests.
Could you do me a favor? If ever you're out here and you know it's going to be a Tuesday morning that you're meeting Ken, Trisha told me about the ice cream that they have evidently up at the, do they still have ice cream up there?
They still have ice cream up at the parlor and the ranch, and then Spruce Saddle has some great delectable meals.
Well, I ask you this because she's talking ice cream, then I think cookies. If you wouldn't mind on a Monday if you're here,
grab a cookie.
Grab a couple extra cookies because I have not been here. What time is cookie hour?
Cookie time is at 3 p.m. in the Centennial and Hay Meadow Base areas. I'll happily grab you a cookie, Ken.
How many cookies have been handed out, would you say, every day?
Ooh, I have no clue. I know that we do about 500,000 cookies throughout the year. I couldn't tell you how many this season so far. I can tell you how many I've eaten.
One a day keeps the doctor close.
Exactly.
I think.
Yes.
Let's do this.
Yes.
I'm not going to say a word. Take it away, Rachel. What happens today at Beaver Creek?
Absolutely. We're connecting Bachelor Gulch and Beaver Creek today. So excited. Primrose and Intertwine are available. And behind us, we've got Strawberry Park opening. Lower Stacker is available. So really excited to open more terrain. Appreciate the patience as we, our snowmakers and our mountain operations teams have been working so hard to get more open. We've got hopefully some more snow in the forecast. So fingers crossed. Really excited to continue to open more of our mountain.
Yay!
Yay!
So, I mean, let's clarify. If I'm right here and I think, hey, kids, let's go over and have one of those. Well, you can't take the kids for an $18 martini. Mom and dad could have one of those delicious $18 martinis at the Ritz. I could go from here up the lift, drop down into Bachelor Gulch, listen to some live music on the deck, have my martini, and then come back over.
Absolutely, you can.
Yes.
So head on over to Bachelor Gulch. And the other thing I'll tell you is, our Riverfront Gondola and Lower Beaver Creek Mountain Express are open. Those are just for travel. Mm-hmm. You cannot ski down yet, but
no leave the beat.
No leave the beat yet.
So wait. You got to think. I love Beaver Creek.
Yeah.
You
got to
remember. I haven't
Absolutely.
Been here. I, you know, I've got my parking over in Vail, but I am starting to frequent here a little bit more. So no leave the beat. But can I take the Weston lift?
Yes.
And then can I get on the Lower Beaver Creek Express and go into Bachelor Gulch?
Yes.
So full access from Avon is what you're saying right
That's
now?
That's what I'm saying right now.
But I can't ski down. I would need to download probably on that, and then I could download on the gondola.
Mm-hmm. You can download on the gondola, or feel free to, you know, use our public transportation system. Pretty easy to get a bus from Beaver Creek Village or Bachelor Gulch.
Thank you so much.
Yeah.
You just educated me. Now I know. But then also clarify, so that's the connection between here and Beaver Creek and Bachelor Gulch. No Arrowhead yet, though.
Not yet. We're still awaiting, you know, some better temperatures, some more snow, and working hard to do it as soon as possible, connecting Arrowhead as well.
All right. Those are the details. So for a quick recap, you can now ski from Beaver Creek over to Bachelor Gulch and vice versa. We have cheer coming up. And the chocolate chip cookies are back. It doesn't get much better. You know, before we started this interview, you and I were talking about when people walk up to you and you say, how you doing? You go, oh, great. And you're not necessarily great. You made me feel great this morning.
Yay!
You made me happy to know that Beaver Creek is like on par for an epic Christmas.
It's going to be amazing. Come out and see us. It's going to be fun and cheer filled. So
what are the ice skating? I meant like the shows that are taking place.
Ooh, you're testing
me.
Oh,
I was going to the details. You are like the Beaver Creek version of Trisha Swenson.
Oh,
she's
going to
pop
about
up
that.
Here. Right? She's going to pop up here in a moment and she'll have some details.
I bet Trisha knows more than me about the ice skating.
Oh, well, you know what? I want to know about the ice bikes. I want to get Ken Hovey out on an ice bike. I think that'd be so fun.
What are those?
So
tell me, what is
ice
that?
Bikes are like old, they're beach cruisers that have been retrofitted. So the front wheel is an ice skate.
Oh, I've seen this on the rink.
And the back wheel has studs so you can get, I've heard it's hard, but I'll do it with you.
Yeah, I'll go. I'll go. anything else, Trisha, before we wrap it up?
Oh, I'm so excited to hear Primrose will get us to Bachelor Gulch. Intertwine will get us back. We've got Sawbuck open. And then that's great news to know that Lift 7 taking you, the Weston Gondola, to the lower Beaver Creek. Not the upper, but the lower. And then we can take Sawbuck down into Bachelor Gulch. Okay, that is good news.
I'm going to take you on the perfect Beaver Creek day today because, let's face it, it's starting to get busy, right? I always suggest now go early.
Yep.
So here's your day. You start off early, right? Go ride, then finish up like 11 o'clock. Park Hyatt, spa. That would be the best.
Ooh, oh, yeah.
I know. Soak it in. Walk out the door. Now, you'd have to time it. You'd probably ride over to Bachelor Gulch, have your martini, come back, get your chocolate chip cookie, and then get a designated driver.
Or take public transportation.
Yes, yeah. Yes. Or, yeah. You know what? And then if you do it on a Thursday, you can stick around for Thursday Night Lights.
Absolutely.
I love that.
Thursday.
All day. Thursday fun day. Okay, perfect. All right, thanks you guys so much. And Rachel, keep us posted on any more openings. We'd love to share that with our audience. So that's wonderful news. Strawberry Park Lift is open for you. Okay, thank you for joining us on VDL today. We will see you tomorrow.
Thanks, Trisha.
Bye. Hi, I'm Trisha Swenson.
I'm Brazzo.
I'm Ashley.
I'm Ken Hovey.
I'm Meredith Kirkman.
I'm Ty Diaz.
I'm Charlie Kennedy.
We are VDL.
We are VDL.
We are VDL.
Vail Daily Live.
We are VDL.
VDL.
We are VDL.